North Korea. The country's state news agency is now reporting that Jang Song-taek, he is the uncle of the leader Kim Jong-un, has been executed. Now, this is a surprise move because until recently, Jang was considered North Korea's second most powerful man. We knew that there was problems in the air, certainly. Earlier this week, images emerged of Jang, who was being led away by uniformed soldiers. That came during a Party Central Committee meeting. He was denounced during that meeting for, and this is how it was described, betraying Kim and the Korean Revolution. For more on the story, let's go to Paula Hancock. She joins us live from Seoul. Paula, what are we to make of this?
Well, Jim, I think some people will be surprised that the fact that Jang Song-taek has actually been executed. After all, he is the uncle of Kim Jong-un. But it really is a very strong message, the strongest message that this young leader could send, that if you don't support him, this is what will happen. So we have understood from state-run media, KCNA, that he was executed. There was a special military tribunal on December the 12th. To find out exactly what he had done. And within the state media article, we are hearing that Jang Song-taek was in fact trying to form a faction and was trying to build his own power base, just threaten that of Kim Jong-un, saying that when Kim Jong-il, the late leader, died, this is when Jang Song-taek began what they call this greed for power. Now, of course, it is a very isolated country. It's not a country you can easily find information from. So we have to take state-run media at face value. This is the message that Kim Jong-un wants to be released. Now, of course, this was just earlier this week that it was confirmed Jang Song-taek had been fired from his post. Remember, we had those very humiliating photos for Jang Song-taek, seeing him being forcibly removed by military personnel from a meeting. And it really is a spectacular fall from grace. And many experts do agree that this is a consolidation of power, and this is a very public message domestically within North Korea that if you dare to disobey Kim Jong-un or not follow him and show complete loyalty, this is what could happen. Jim?
Paula, I'm going to ask you to continue standing by there, but I want to allow our viewers in Europe to switch away now and to watch Amanpour, already in progress. Paula, as we look at this, obviously a power struggle, but a swift denunciation followed even more swiftly by an execution. What does this say about the power base of the young leader, Kim Jong-un?
Well, it's interesting. One expert I spoke to said that if he was completely in power in North Korea, and if he did feel that he had full authority of the country, then maybe he wouldn't need to actually do this so publicly. Maybe he wouldn't have needed to publicly humiliate his uncle, and of course then to execute it. We now have learned this Friday morning. But others say that this just shows that he is determined to keep that power base, and he will stop at nothing, even executing his own uncle. Now, of course, Jang Song-taek was considered the second most powerful man in the country. He was put into place by Kim Jong-il, the late leader who trusted him implicitly. This is what's being said in this state-run media article, that Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il trusted him. And he was basically put in place so that he could guide the young leader. Once Kim Jong-un took over, Jang Song-taek was considered to be the power behind the throne. He was considered to be the one, by some analysts, as the one pulling the strings and trying to help Kim Jong-un grow into this role. And now all of a sudden you see that he has been dismissed by Kim Jong-un and he has been executed. Another expert I spoke to on North Korea was saying this shows that Kim Jong-un is actually more brutal than his father and his grandfather. The fact that he is willing to carry something like this out, even though he is family. Jim?
I know that it's very hard to see into the affairs of North Korea, being a closed nation, perhaps the most closed nation on earth. But what does this tell us about what might happen in the future? Because there seem to be hints that there may have been others who were involved. If he's willing to do this to his uncle, their fate might be sealed as well.
Absolutely. The message could not be clearer. Even though Chun Sun-taek was family, he was still executed because he did not show loyalty to Kim Jong-un. This is a very clear message. And it is interesting, this message, for an international audience, but it's very much a domestic issue. This is what Kim Jong-un is showing the people within North Korea. This is what he is telling to the elite and anybody else who may be considering not showing him complete and utter loyalty. The message really couldn't be clearer. We heard from South Korean intelligence earlier this week. They believed that some of Chun Sun-taek's allies had been executed. Now, of course, that wasn't confirmed from North Korea, but you see that his uncle is executed. It lays credence to those reports, and you would imagine that if he is willing to execute his uncle, then he would not necessarily think twice about executing those allies around him. We did hear from North Korea earlier this week, and he did say, Kim Jong-un, through state-run media, did say that this was not an individual effort by his uncle to try and grasp power and to build this power base within the ruling Workers' Party. This was done by a number of different people. So you can only assume that the fate of those people would have been very similar to the fate of his uncle.
Paula Hancox, you say it, and rightly so, this is an entirely internal affair. But when it comes to North Korea, nothing is more important than the survival of the Kim dynasty, the regime itself. What happens now to the international agenda? Do we expect to see North Korea turning inwards, at least for the foreseeable future?
It's very difficult to say. I would assume that that might happen, because if it has got to the point where Kim Jong-un has had to execute his uncle and has had to basically air his dirty laundry in public, which is very unusual for a country like North Korea to be publicly admitting that there was this problem and publicly showing that there was actually a defiance towards Kim Jong-un. This is not something we've really seen much of before, certainly not with the two previous leaders. Whether or not there were these problems before, it's not known, and whether they were dealt with quietly. But to actually air the dirty laundry in public like this is really quite unusual. So you would assume that this country, for the foreseeable future, for the short term, would look inwards, and that Kim Jong-un would have to look to his own country and to his own power and the elite and check that there are no other individuals or groups that are trying to take power from him. Now, of course, I have to say once again, we don't know for sure if this is actually what happened. All we can do is look at state-run media and see the message that they are giving out. So it does have to be taken at face value. But you could assume that they would be looking inward, certainly for the short term.